Hi, ladies and gentlemen. This is Dr. Julian Avila, and this question and answer goes out to all of my beautiful cousins in Baltimore, Maryland. I got a question sent by one of them who happens to be pregnant right now and had a question of, is it okay to have ceviche while you're pregnant? Now, this is runs into a kind of gray area, so let's go over the different possibilities and different management plans related to fish. Number one, in general, because you can go through different societies, you can go through ACOG, American Congress of Obstetricians and Gynecologists versus the FDA. You can go through the Centers for Disease Control. There's a lot of different opinions on how and how much and what type of fish you can have when you're pregnant. Number one, in general, you can have fish somewhere between 6 ounces and 12 ounces of fish per week. Number two, it's almost always recommended that you have fish that has already been treated as a frozen product and then fully cooked up to 145 degrees. And that will take care of both parasites as well as bacteria and viruses. And when you go parasites and bacteria and virus, you don't even want to eat that. But fish is very good for you to eat while you're pregnant. And so let's keep that in mind. Number one, fully cooked, 145 degrees Fahrenheit, and also that it should have been frozen, especially if you're going to eat it like sushi or raw and untreated. Number two, or next point, has specifically to do with what type of fish. Now, if you understand that if you eat fish that's a larger prey, that eats smaller fish, then the amount of mercury, which is the main thing that we're worried about, because mercury can affect the baby's brain development as well as eye development. And if you eat large fish that eat on the smaller fish, then we might have a problem there, such as swordfish and mackerel. We have to be careful of those. What is acceptable to eat are the smaller fish, and I'm not really into eating smaller fish like sardines or fish like of that sort that's been treated with a lot of salt contact, but you can eat that. So next point, can you have sushi? Well, in moderation, but you should always try to have fully cooked, but in moderation, as long as it's been treated professionally, then you can have some sushi. The next point is the eating tuna, because a lot of people like to eat tuna. Tuna is acceptable, but here we get in a difference of opinion on how much. Some say that only 4 ounces a week. Some say that you can have up to 12 ounces a week. And it should be treated tuna, not raw tuna, obviously. And light or white tuna is okay to eat, but again, in moderation. So for those that really like tuna fish, you can have it in moderation, anywhere between 4 and 12 ounces per week, depending on the source. And there are some people that recommend no tuna whatsoever, but I find it hard to not say that it's okay to eat some. Another point is shellfish. Shellfish, such as shrimp and oysters and clams, they must always be treated. They must always be treated because of the potential for carrying parasites and viruses. They should be completely treated, completely cooked. And here's where we run into the problem with ceviche, because if you've ever had Peruvian ceviche, which happens to be the best, then you're going to run into the fact that you have shrimp as well as clams, sometimes oysters added to the ingredients, and the lime juice in it is not enough to cook completely through for the ceviche. Although I happen to love ceviche that's 2 days old, because the lime juice has really been able to make it taste fantastic. So if you ever have a chance, getting off subject, always try to find somebody that can make some really good Peruvian ceviche, and you're good to go on that point. So Don't skip out on eating fish altogether, because it does have a high amount of nutrients. But as I said before, try to take it in the manner of fully cooked and or that it's been frozen and then treated afterwards. If you're going to be concerned that fish is something that you don't want to take in because of the possibility of a high mercury content, then always remember to take your prenatal vitamins that already have omega-3 and other ingredients that are commonly found in fish already in the pill itself. And always try to take one that doesn't give you that aftertaste of having burped the taste of fish. So a lot of prenatal vitamins nowadays do already have omega-3 in them, which makes up for some of the loss of fresh fish that's fully cooked. So I hope this answers your question. Number one, please eat the larger fish in moderation. Oh, tilapia, by the way, is a main ingredient in ceviche. So you can, but again, it has to be fully cooked. So that's a catch-22 on that point. So and you can have tuna, but in moderation, and it should be I mean canned tuna. Keep that in mind, and always cook shellfish, shrimp, clams, oysters. They should always be fully cooked before you eat them. I hope this out helps out in answering the question of whether or not you can have fish and how much. And send me more questions. I'll be glad to answer them. Thank you very much.